Hey guys, it's Mr. 250 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda the Wind Waker. And, I just got back from GameStop, went and purchased a used GameCube there. Ooh, hello. What is that? Is that a pot? Pot? Yes! Sneaky pot! I have found thee! Okay. Yeah. Purchased a new GameCube. Well, used GameCube. And it's no. Oh, I hate this guy. Oh, if you'll please, young boy there, please help me. Please listen to my tale of woe. Okay. Oh, my sweet, sweet daughter. My only daughter, poor Maggie. She was captured by a bunch of villains and taken to the Forsaken Fortress. What on earth could those scoundrels want with her? Are they just roaming around looking for young maidens? Are they just evil creatures who delight in mischief? Well, crud. Having a kidnapped daughter doesn't get you a single rupee, you know. Please, please, save my poor daughter, I beg of you. Here I stand, begging. I hope you'll give those scoundrels in the Forsaken Fortress a good scare. They'll pay for what they've done. Oh, yes, pay. Alright, cool. Anyway, like what I was saying, I've got a, I got this GameCube controller now. And it's a little weird, but it's not too bad. It's like, I went to GameStop and I got a refurbished GameCube, and they give you a GameCube and a GameCube controller, but, like, I got a PlayStation 2 the same way, and this GameCube refurbished. They give you, like, a bootleg one. Like, this doesn't say Nintendo anywhere on the thing. Like, there's a spot on the front that's supposed to say Nintendo, it's blank. There's a little spot on the back, it should say Nintendo, it's blank. But, it doesn't. But the big difference for me that really makes this nice is when I push up, I actually go up, and I don't go down. And the control stick works without sticking, so... You know what? Because they had new controllers there for, $15? $30? I'd rather go for a $30 controller.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, hello, hello. You are standing in the one and only Chew Jelly Juice Shop. You must have heard, our potions are the best. I'm telling you, they're too good. In fact, they're absolutely incredible. What's that? What's chew jelly, you ask, looking somewhat bewildered. Oh, sir, you simply must be joking. You don't know what chew jelly is. Well, just ask yourself this, good sir. What is a robustly nourishing element? What is a mystical substance that is good for the body and mind? Ask yourself. The words chew jelly roar out in answer to these questions, proclaiming themselves to be true. Why, it is the key ingredient in the most effective potions around. All you have to do is bring an empty bottle to my little juice shop here, and I'll let you have a taste. Which begs the question, sir. Do you have an empty bottle?
No.
I don't. Hold on. Let me take a drink. All this talking is making me really thirsty. Okay. So, we can buy that chew jelly there. Although, not yet. As soon as we get an empty bottle. Yay, rupee! Oh, blue rupee. Hello there. No, chair. You're in the way, Mr. Chair. Please, step aside. The control stick is a little odd, but it's controllable. It's just I think the springs in it are a little bad, but they do go where you want them to go. You have to put a little more force into it than I'd like. Alright, ooh, let's go to the fancy house. I remember this place. Alright. This is, I think you can buy things. Auction things here. And I believe you get in trouble if you break one of these. Ah! You little weasel! Well, thank you so much for coming into my home and breaking my high-priced vases. Told you, Mr. 250, someone was gonna get mad about that. If you break anymore, I assure you I will not let it go lightly. No, sir, not at all. I require compensation.
Whatever, noob.
Let's get out of here. Yep, not gonna break any more of those. Don't feel like paying my hard-earned rupees that I stole, probably. Why, hello there, Mr. Eskimo Man. How are you doing? My story is a strange one. I came across a curse from a land far away. A land where blizzards blow violently, heading for this town called Windfall. But dear me, as I traveled, a terrible storm descended and tore my ship to bits. Yet mysteriously, only that escaped without so much as a mark on it. From the looks of you, I would say you are a traveler as well. Oh yes, indeed. Could you not purchase that from me? It is my one and only heirloom from home. The people of this town do not seem the least bit interested in that, despite the fact that it would help them travel the dangerous seas about their town. Please, I beg of you. I wish to open a business here in this town, so I am in desperate need of finances. How does 80 rupees sound? Well, I always do like things. Yes, yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Indeed, I have received precisely 80 rupees for it. You can use these funds to finance my new business. Oh, dear me, what a happy day. Very well, young master. As I promised, please, take that. Ta-da! You got a boat sail set to X, Z, Y, Z, or X. Then use it to sail on your boat to sail across the sea. Press A to put it away. Yes, yes, yes. You have made a good purchase today, my young master. And you have saved my life and business as well. Treasure it dearly. It is the finest sail in the world. Treat it as such. Cool. So, we got le sail, which we can set it to one of our buttons. Don't know which one. We'll set it to Y. Okay. Cool, so we got a sail that only costs like a fortune. Hello there. How are you doing? People from all over this world seem to gather here on Windfall Island, all hoping to become successful merchants. I can't talk today. I suppose you could say that this is the island where people and money come together. But you know what? Money is important, sure. But don't you think people need to open their hearts a little more than their wallets? I've been kicking around this crazy world for a long time, and I've learned to stop and sniff the flowers along the way. Indeed, this man knows what he's talking about. Let's grab this ninja vase. Ninja behind that tree? I don't think so. I'll steal all your rupee goodness. Hello there. Hey there, boy. Do you happen to see the postbox down near the docks? Well, just so you know, if you want to send someone a letter, set it to Y, Z, or X, and use that button to put it in the postbox. It's just that easy. Before long, the Rito postman will come to deliver it to whomever you send it to. He's a hard-working fellow, I tell you. Why do these people keep talking about X, Y, and Z? What are they talking about? All right. What is this house? Oh, hello there. I remember you. No, let me move.
Now, I would have to say I've never seen your face before, have I? Now, intriguing. Beguiling. I know you're just a small child, but I found one can rarely trust strangers. Where is it you come from, young sir?
I'm sorry, but the years have made me wary. Once long ago, I rented a room out to a traveler for a single night. The next dawn, my precious picto box was stolen.
Tell me, young sir, why are good deeds so often repaid with cruelty?
I spread kindness where I can, and still, my box does not come back to me. It is a sad thing. You may look like a child, but you can see why I cannot be assured of your youth. Be a good boy and be gone. Shoo! Shoo!
Oh, come on. What kind of way is that to talk to the boy wearing the Hero of Legend clothes and having a hero sword and hero shield? Come on.
At least a little common courtesy would be nice. What's up, midgets? I mean, tiny people. Yo, bud. You looking for a picto box or something? Yeah! Thought so. There ain't nothing in this town that we killer bees don't know.
Boss, I heard this from my dad. A while back, this thief stole a picto box, and he was held in the town jail for a long, long time. Yeah, real long. That thief managed to get free after a while, but the box he stole never got found.
Uh-huh. Maybe it's still hidden somewhere in the jail cell, don't you think? Maybe.
Give me a break. How stupid would that be? Real stupid, that's how stupid.
I hate these kids. They're so annoying. Leave me alone, you little worms! Okay, cool. So, although, you know, we can get that sale like we were talking about, let's do a couple other things, like find this picture box.
Yep, to sailors like us, the wind's our whole life.
It'd sure be nice if a fair wind blew today.
Well, the wind's very nice. Can't you see it by all the little wind particles, the little wind streams?
Hello there.
Well, what do you think about my outfit? You don't see clothes like this often, do you? Aren't they cute? A friend of mine who lives on the outside island sent this outfit to me. She's an amazing girl. She can put jars on her head and walk around like it's nothing at all. You have to see it to believe it. It's that chick in our town who's walking around with a jar on her head. That's who gave it her. Oh, I think there's a game in here, actually. Hello.
Hey.
Hey, welcome. It's 10 rupees per game for kids. You want to play or what? Sure, let's give it a shot. Yeah, okay then. Ahem.
Welcome to the fleet. I am the great Admiral Doska Valkyzy. Look sharp, for they are the sole protectors of this island.
Admiral, red alert, all hands on deck. Sonar shows that schools of deadly giant squids are approaching. All ships prepare for battle. What? Veer? Ahoo! I see the fiends approach. There are three squid groups. A large one, a medium one, and a small one. If they allow them to come any closer, the children on the island will be in grave danger. Sailor, take command of our new radar system to seek out and sink all of these fiendish hidden enemies. But Z warned, you have only 24 cannonballs that you can fire. To destroy the marauding squid pods, you must score 4 direct hits on the large, 3 on the medium, and 2 on the small. Use control stick to move the cursor, and press A to fire a cannon blast. May your aim be true, that is all. That is all the instruction you need. Is that clear, sailor?
Aye, aye, sir.
Excellent. So far, our best sailor has managed to destroy all of the giant squid using only 20 cannonballs. May you fight as bravely.
Okay, let me see if I can remember how to do this.
Splish.
Okay, splish means... That's such a weird sound effect.
Splish.
That means you missed.
Kaboom! Kaboom! Kaboom!
Okay, we got the large squid, I believe.
Splish.
Splish. It's kind of like Battleship,
splish,
honestly.
Splish, splish,
I used to be really good at this, even though it's not exactly hard.
Splish, splish,
splish,
splish.
Oh wow, I'm doing really bad.
Splish, kaboom, splish.
Okay.
Kaboom.
Okay, we got the small one, and now we got one left.
Splish, splish, splish. Kaboom, kaboom, kaboom.
You're kidding me. I missed it? By one. Oh, bad news. A sailor, the enemies have retreated or something. It's 10 rupees per game per kids. Want to try again? Yeah, I want to try this till I win. Okay, then, Excellent. So far, our best sailor has managed to destroy all of the giant squid using only 20 cannonballs. May you fight as bravely. Okay.
Splish.
Just gonna take some pot shots out here and see if we can find one.
Splish. Splish.
It's a little bit like Battleship, honestly.
Splish. Splish.
Only it's a bit more annoying.
Splish.
Because you have to do it in a certain amount of turns.
Splish.
Ooh, gone.
Kaboom.
Okay, last one's right here.
Kaboom.
Ooh, we got the large one. There we go.
Splish.
Kaboom. Okay.
Kaboom.
And you got the medium one. Oh, I missed the last one. Crap. Okay. I'm not wasting any more money on this. Oh, bad news, a sailor. The enemies have retreated or something. No, no, we are not playing this again. No, crap! Didn't mean to press that. Okay. Let's try again. Just so you know, this game would be absolutely impossible with that other controller I had. Large one down. Medium one, and we have the small one left. 16, 17. Got him! We got it the high score too. Well, we got exactly the high score.
Excellent work, sailor. Your deeds have successfully protected the peace on this upper island. We are very proud. The children on the island would like to thank you, sailor.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Oh, thank you, Mr. Sailor. Please take this piece of heart as a sign of our gratitude. You are so great.
You got a piece of heart! Collect 4 of these to complete a new heart container. More heart containers equals more life. So, thanks for playing and all that. I can't tell you how fun it's been for me. And I don't forget the umbrella or nothing on the way out of the door. Cool. Alright. Excellent. We got a piece of heart, which we want to collect tons of those so that we can get more health. I didn't really mean to do that last one, honestly. Let's go take a ride on the windmill. Oh! Hello there. You know, this thing may look like a windmill, but it's actually a wind-powered Ferris wheel. It's used to harness the wind's power to spin in quite a nifty manner. But we rarely get a favorable wind around here, so it doesn't budge. I'm pretty sure it's not broken yet, though, so if the wind blew in the right direction again, we just have to hit the power switch out back to get it moving. Looks like a westerly wind is blowing now. Yeah, so I guess we can't ride that yet. But, no spoilers, but we will soon. Oh, and this is just a classroom, and I think I can actually get something in here. Let me check, I can't remember. It's been, like, a year since I played this, and it's been a year since I've gone and done everything. Hello. Welcome to Miss Mary's School of Joy! I don't think I've ever seen your face around here, my young scholar. Are you a new pupil? Oh, is that it? What can I do for you on this fine day? We need to talk, ma'am. I know I may look a bit flashy for a teacher, but I assure you I am one. How long has it been since I opened my school here on Windfall Island? 20 years? Ever since then, I've been teaching the children of this island about true joy. But I do have a rather joyless problem. There's this delinquent gang of 4 young boys who never listen to a word I say. Even though I wait patiently for those boys to show up, they never come. It's as if they don't want joy in their hearts. Could you please catch their leader, that little boy named Ivan, and talk some sense into him for me? Please, young man, for me? Yes, ma'am! Oh, thank you very much. You're such a dear. They're such troublesome little boys. I'm at wit's end over how to handle them. But they won't be so mean to a boy their own age, will they? I should think not. Good luck, young man. Yeah, about that, those kids are pretty mean. But let's go see if maybe I can talk some sense into them using this B button here. Oh, I can't pull it out right now. Okay. Hey, what's up? Yo, bud, you looking for a picto box or something? Oh, we already read this. Look, I don't care what you have to say. I wanted to talk sense into you. Okay, whatever. Cool. Let's just get out of here. Go up the big ramp. Let's see where this goes. I can't remember. Oh, this is, like, the back door to that rich guy's house. Yep, the rich guy is over here. Your fireplace, it's gone out. PK fire! Okay, I wonder if a boy like you will do. It's difficult to tell, yes, difficult. You see, my one and only daughter, Mila, is taken from me to a frightening place called the Forsaken Fortress. I have asked many to rescue her, but it seems to be a difficult voyage to that cursed place. Oh, to see my sweet Mila again, my precious little daughter. I worry so over her welfare. I can't recall the last time I slept more than a wink. I sincerely wonder about the wisdom of asking a boy like you to do this. But would you lend a hand to help rescue my precious daughter? Sure. You are a brave boy to take on this task, I assure you. If you do rescue her, I will pay you as much money as it takes. I'll give you my entire fortune for her safety. Cool. We're gonna get rich. Oh man, I wanted to knock those down. Okay, can I claw? Not claw. Climb. Yes. Drop. Let go. Hello, stage. I forget. It's like a certain time at night you can actually go up here and, buy things for auction. Some of them are really good, like there's some heart pieces and cool stuff like that. You got a red rupee! Wow, I just totally robbed this guy. That's my prepayment. That's what you gotta pay me to go get your daughter, just to start off. Alright. Let's see, is there anyone else I can talk to around here? Let's go get that picto box. I can't quite remember where the jail was. Yep. Oh, hello there. Yep. Oh, no, blue rupee! I missed it. Nope, don't target the pig. We have no quarrel with you, pig. Oh, no. Blue rupee went away. I wanted it. Okay. You don't look all familiar, buddy. Are you come kind of tourist or something? If you are, I'll show you around. Why don't you join me for a little stroll around town? Our Windfall Island may be a little cozy, so to speak, but the people from all over the world come here. This town's always lively. Well, just walking around and having a look at things is fun. That's the mark of a great town. Cool. Oh, let's go talk to Elvis over here. I don't know, he kind of made me always think of Elvis. Oh, that's not it. That's not it. And the problem is, even though that's not it, this isn't it either. Huh? Oh dear, pardon me, guy. I was so fully and wholly absorbed in my dancing, I didn't even notice little old you standing there. I am Tot. I love dancing more than I love three meals a day. You'll come to know me as the world's charismatic dancer extraordinaire. Ready, guy? One, two, one, two. Say, guy, you know what I was just reminded of? Long ago, I met this delightful little guy who performed the most dazzling magic dance. A dance that turned night into day right before my eyes. I can remember those fabulous dance moves, but I just can't seem to get that intricate rhythm down. Do you think you know the rhythm, guy? AKA, there's a... First of all, why is he dancing in front of a grave? That's kind of creepy. Nope. Oh, don't fall off. Okay. Yeah, that's a guy we can come back to later for a little something special, but I believe this is the jail? Is it? Ah, here we go. Oh gosh, it's this guy. Hello, Tangle. How are you doing? I see the same green clothes and the same green hat. By the look of you, I'd say, sir, can you know I can't be a fairy or a leprechaun? Wow. Goodness, did you feel my telepathy? That's why you saved me, isn't it? Isn't it? Isn't it? Do not worry, Tingle knows without you telling him. Sir? Yes, sir? Tingle is my name. I have been looking for you and your kind, for I too long to be one of the fairy folk. And yet, I was mistaken for some kind of troublemaker and put into this dreadful sort of place. How disrespectful. Please, Mr. Fairy, rescue poor Tingle from this place and take him to where you and your kind live in splendor. Gosh. Mom told me to stay away from people like him. Could you please go away? This is really creepy. I'm so glad that's the unlocking mechanism is a big button.
Yay!
Thank you so very much! Here's Tingle's heartfelt gift of thanks! Tingle! Tingle! Kululimpa! Common item. I said that weird. He gave you the Dingle Tuner. If you ever get stuck or need a quick hint, connect a Game Boy Advance to your Nintendo GameCube and talk to Tingle. Too bad I only have a DS. After connecting the Game Boy Advance to controller socket 2, 3, or 4, set the Tingle Tuner to Y, Z, or X to call Tingle. Now, no matter how far we travel from this dingy cell, our souls will be as one. Splendid, Tingle is going to get ready to go to the realm of the fairies, so you just wait here, okay, sir? Ah! I was forgetting something important. Oh, Mr. Fairy! You want to come to my island, don't you? Don't you? Don't you? You got Tingle's chart. What kind of chart could it be? Head out to sea, then press up and check your charts to find out. When you go out to sea, open it. If you ever need any help with your charts, just leave it to Tingle. Don't ever forget it. If you ever need help with the charts, don't forget it. That guy was weird. Okay. Let's keep going. So, in here... Well, first off, somebody hit a rupee. And second off... Let's see. Whoops. Nope. There we go. Back here is a little tunnel. So there's a couple traps in here we have to look out for. Okay, and we'll need to do this periodically. Okay. Oh, no, 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 no! I didn't tell it to go that way! No! Crap. Stupid mice. Oh, oh, that look in your eyes. So you found yourself a sail, have you? Very well, I teach you the art of sailing. No, I don't want to sail. I'm drowning. Blah, blah, blah. Come next to my hull and press A to climb aboard. Set the sail you've got to Y, Z, or X and press that same button to hoist it. The sail will catch the wind, which will push the boat forward. The up direction means... The up direction that appears behind me indicates the wind direction. Use that to steer. If you wish to move quickly, you should keep the wind blowing directly into the sail. You can always press A to put away the sail. Try it when you want to adjust your speed. Yes, I understood all that. One more thing, when you're out at sea with few landmarks to go by, you'll be at the mercy of your sea chart. I have marked a place we should currently be heading for on your sea chart. If you get lost at sea, simply press up to open the chart and confirm your position. Now, a westerly wind blows, hop in and let's carry us to the east. Well, I didn't really want to go to you yet, I was trying to get through... get to the end of here. What? Can't you see we're busy? I know we're super cute and all, but that doesn't mean you can just come and talk to us like that. Jeepers. Didn't want to talk to you anyway, girl. No, 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 no. No, no, sir. I don't want to talk to you right now. That guy's annoying. Okay, here we go. Back into the cell. Okay, so... we need to look out for wooden planks. Wooden planks mean that those are directions that the rats have trapdoors set up. And it's kind of weird because I didn't tell it to go that way, but I kind of did. If that makes sense. Okay. Ooh, what's that? Oh, okay, never mind. Like a maze in here, but there's one path that you, if you take it, then it'll... Oh, hello there. I didn't know we could do this in first person mode. Let's do that. That's a lot simpler. Oh, nope, we're not going... we're not going that way. Rupee! Forward. And there's a wooden panel to our left that we don't want to go on. Play the game Legend of Zelda in first person mode. Here we go. Da 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 da. It's kind of creepy. There's like a bunch of skulls around here, and did I just break that skull? Link, the power to throw rocks is in your hand. Oh yeah, this person had something stuck in their skull, like a rupee. Ooh, yellow. Is there another one in here? Ooh, what's that say? Mm-mm. Data note. At last, I've succeeded in stealing the picto box I've desired for so long. Succeeded, yes, but sadly. Due to a slight mistake on my part, I was also caught. I've been in prison, but I do not give in easily. I refuse to give this wondrous box to my captors. I've decided to hide it here in the depths of my cell and then make it my escape by tunneling out. Yes, that is my plan. Of course, if I ever successfully escape from this prison, I shall one day return to recover the Pictobox. I will write the controls for it in case I should forget them. Set it to Y, Z, or X on this item screen. Press A to snap shots. Use that to zoom in and out. Press R to switch to its delightful pictograph viewing mode. It saves up to 3 pictographs at one time. Oh, how it pains me to leave it. I wish I could just get out of here so I could start taking pictographs. Yeah. Let's go take some pictures. You got the picto box. Set it to and use it with blah. You can hold up 3 pictographs. Yep. Okay. So let's set this to Z. So you can sort of like the telescope. Actually, it's exactly like the telescope. Whoops! Didn't mean to swap mode. Now, you can only hold 3 pictures, but you can always delete one. So, it's sort of like a digital camera with a really, really small, really small size. And I don't feel like going back to this whole thing. So let's go over here. And we'll get out of here a lot faster. Splash. Hello there. I'm back. Alright. So that little arrow means that's the direction the wind's blowing. If we press R, we can actually get a little momentum out of here. And then opening our sail will give us an extremely big increase in speed. But, I think I'm going to stop here for today because we're out of time. And I'll just make another episode, but we're out of time. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. And if you did, comments are accepted, approved, and deeply enjoyed. All right. Thanks, guys. See you next time. Bye.